students will define few terms before going to detail of refraction of light. Let us define few terms which are generally used. Now, what are the few terms that are used? Let us say this is a surface which separates two media. So, this surface is called interface. Okay, what is the interface? Interface is a surface which separates two media. Suppose there is air over here, this is medium 1, and water below, medium number 2. So, this is a surface which separates two media. Next. The point where the ray strikes the surface, the point here, the point where the ray strikes the surface is called point of incidence. This point, suppose this point is called P, this is called A, the AP is called incident ray. Point P is called point of incidence. Because it is the point where the ray strikes the surface. This medium, if it is air, it can be any other medium, it can be also any other medium. This is the first medium, this is the second medium. If it is air, then it is rarer medium. If it is water, then it is denser medium. Now, this is the original direction. In the absence of water, the rays would have traveled, followed this path. This is called the A dash, suppose. A, P, A dash, this line, this path is the original path. This lines M, N is called normal. In this case, air to water, it will deviate from the original direction and bend towards the normal. This is suppose B. So now PB is called refracted ray. It's called refracted ray. And this angle that is formed here we call this angle I. This is called angle of incidence. So, angle of incidence is which angle? APM. It is the angle between the incident ray and the normal, not the incident ray and the surface. Similarly, this angle is called angle of refraction. Yeah. this angle is called angle of refraction, that is NPB. This angle from original to the normal. So this is how the normal goes, this direction, this angle is same as angle I, alternate angle, opposite angles, because this is 90, these two are 90, so this angle will be opposite to this angle, so it is same angle I. This angle between the refracted ray and original, this is the angle through which the ray in the original direction is deviated. So this is called angle of deviation and represented with delta. So delta is what? B P A dash. This is called angle of deviation. What is angle of deviation? Angle of deviation is the angle through which the original ray is deviated in the direction of the final ray. So this original ray is deviated by this angle in the direction of the final ray. You are supposed to go to school, a school is in this direction from your house, and there is cinema over here. Instead of going straight, you go to that place. So this is the initial direction, and this was, you landed up there. So this is the angle that you get deviated. So this angle is called the angle of deviation. The original direction and the final directions. The angle between the original direction and the final direction. This original direction is this. And the final ray goes like this. So what angle they make, this is called delta, that is known as the angle of deviation. So this delta I and R have certain relationship, as you can see here. You can see that this total angle is I, this angle is delta, and this angle is R. So I is R plus delta. So there is a relation I equals to R plus delta. Whenever delta is asked, we can write this I minus R. This formula you can use. So these are the terms you must know. This angle, one more angle is also called as this angle. Suppose this angle is called phi. This phi angle is called glancing angle. What is glancing angle? It is the angle between the incident ray and the surface. This is called as glancing angle. You can also see that when a ray of light moves from rarer medium to denser medium, it bends towards the normal. That means I is greater than R. And vice versa, I will be less than R. That means if it moves from denser medium to rarer medium, I will be less than R. So that's all in the definition of terms. Thank you, and we'll move into the next video.